G'day everybody, welcome to another tutorial. This week I'm going to show you how to create this chalk effect in Affinity Photo. So as usual, let's get started. Let's come across to the picture we're going to use today, which is this picture of a Volkswagen. I've already made a selection of the Volkswagen, as you can see here, using my selection brush tool. So the next thing we need to do now is click on refine, and let's just use our brush to clean up any little areas here that we might have missed. There, so that's looking pretty good. On our refine selection box here, let's change our smoothing to 4 and feather to 4 as well. On our output box, let's click on new layer and click on apply, and this will give us our Volkswagen on its very own layer without the background. And on that layer, let's hit command C to copy this layer, and we're going to paste it over here onto our chalkboard. So let's go command V to paste that onto our chalkboard. Let's grab our move tool and let's just reposition the Volkswagen, make it a little bit bigger and leave some room up the top for some text. On our Volkswagen layer, I'm going to copy that layer twice with a command J. So put two more copies, and the two bottom copies let's turn off for now. The first thing we're going to do is add a black and white adjustment layer down here on our adjustments and click on black and white. Let's clip the black and white adjustment layer to our van layer below by clicking and dragging, and let's clip that to the layer below. On our van layer, once we've got our black and white adjustment clip, let's come up to filters, detect and detect edges. Let's change the blend mode to screen. We're going to add another filter. We're going to come back to our filters, down here to colors this time, and all the way down to solarize. And if anyone is wondering what the effect solarize does, I'll pop that up on the screen now. We're going to add a levels adjustment now. So let's come down here to our adjustments and click on levels. On our levels box, I'm just going to adjust my black level to about 7. I'm going to drop the gamma down a tiny little bit. I'm going to bring the output white down a little bit and our white level just down a little bit as well. That is looking pretty good. I'm really happy with the way that looks at the moment. So let's clip that levels adjustment to our Volkswagen as well. I'm going to add a new layer down here on our new layers. And on our new layer here, I'm going to grab my paintbrush tool. And on my brushes, I'm going to have my pencil brushes selected. And I'm going to select this one here, number 12. Let's drop the hardness on this brush all the way down to 0. Have our flow up at 20 and our opacity at 20 as well. So let's flow and opacity at 20 and hardness 0. Let's make our brush a little bit bigger with our right and left bracket keys. And on the tires down here, let's just draw in a circle around the tires here. And let's cover the middle up a little bit as well. Let's do the same to the other tire here. Just draw in a circle on the tire and cover up that middle bit as well. Let's drop our brush a little bit smaller and add some more detail to the front tire. There we go, looking pretty good. Okay, if you want to make some of these lines a little bit more chalky as well, let's just up the opacity to about 25 and the flow as well to about 25. I'm going to make my brush quite small, and on that line there, I'm just going to click once, hold down my shift key, position it on the other end and click again. We might have to do that a couple of times. So let's go back the other way. Click once, hold down your shift key and click again, and we'll get that line looking a little bit more chalkier. And that looks pretty good. The next thing I'm going to do is just show you how to add some color to your picture if you like, and that's using one of the original layers here. Let's click on the original layer and drag it above the van layer. Now on our original layer here, we can drop the opacity all the way down to about 5%, really, really low. And as you can see, it adds a little bit of color to our chalk effect. I'm going to click off mine because I'm going to leave it just with the chalk effect. And the last thing I'm going to do for my picture here is add a text layer over here to my text box, and I'm just going to drag that out and type in my van. You can type in anything that you like. I'm going to drag it just about on top of the van, make it a little bit bigger. I'm going to highlight my text. I'm up here to my text up here on the toolbar and click on show character. I'm going to change my font to chalk duster, which is down here, chalk duster, and I'm going to just drop the opacity a little bit on that text. There we go. And one last little trick we can do if you want to, once we put our color layer on top, you could bring the color all the way back to 100%. We can grab our rectangular tool here and we could drag that and make a selection of half of our van and hit delete and get rid of your selection with escape or command D, and you could have the effect of half chalk and half full color. So there you go, everybody. That is the chalk effect in Affinity Photo. If you've enjoyed the tutorial this week, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing. Until next time, I'll say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.